Welcome to today's comprehensive guide on macOS Sequoia Firewall. Should I allow or block incoming connections? This video will answer your questions about configuring the macOS Sequoia Firewall rules to enhance the security of your MacBook Pro, MacBook Air, iMac, or Mac Mini. To access the firewall settings on macOS Sequoia, click on System Settings in the dock. Next, click the Network icon in the left sidebar and select the Firewall pane. Turn on the toggle switch to activate the default settings. To customize the macOS Sequoia Firewall further, click the Options button. The first option is to block all incoming connections. This rule is too strict, and enabling it may cause some applications to stop working properly. File sharing and remote access services will also be blocked. I recommend keeping this option turned off, unless you are in an environment that requires blocking all incoming connections. If that's the case, turn it on. Otherwise, it is best to leave it turned off. The Control Center manages macOS functionalities like Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, AirDrop, and system notifications. If allowed, external devices or services can interact effectively with the control center. If blocked, features relying on external communication, for example, AirDrop and continuity, may not work. Therefore, I select Allow. COPS, Common UNIX Printing System Daemon, manages print services and allows computers and printers to connect to your Mac for printing tasks. If you use network printers, you should allow them. If not, you can safely block them. Since I don't use network printers, I block the inbound connections. Python 3 executes Python 3 scripts and applications, which might be necessary for certain software and automation tasks. These are often used by developers or system processes. Allow it if you run Python-based applications that require network access. Otherwise, it can be blocked. Rapport provides security for online banking and other sensitive transactions. Financial institutions often use it to protect user data. Select Allow to ensure secure transactions and protect sensitive information. Remoted manages remote desktop connections, allowing you to access and control your Mac from another device. Allow this if you use remote desktop services. If not, it can be blocked. Ruby executes Ruby scripts and applications, which might be necessary for certain software and development tasks. Allow if you run Ruby-based applications that require network access. Otherwise, it can be blocked. Sharing manages file sharing, AirDrop, handoff, and sharing computers, enabling you to share files with other devices on the network. Allow if you use file sharing or AirDrop. If not, it can be blocked. I don't share files with others, so I choose block. However, if you use AirDrop or handoff select allow. SMBD, Server Message Block Daemon, manages file sharing, which is commonly used to share files between different operating systems. If you use SMB file sharing, allow it. If not, it can be blocked. I'll choose block. sshd-keygen-wrapper manages SSH secure shell, key generation, and connections. It is used when initially connecting to a Mac remotely via SSH. This service is essential for secure remote access and key generation. Choose allow if you use SSH to access your Mac or other devices remotely. Block it if you don't use SSH for remote access. I select block. Universal Control allows seamless control of multiple Apple devices with a single keyboard and mouse. This feature is particularly useful if you frequently switch between devices like a Mac, iPad, or another Mac. Allow if you use Universal Control. If not, it can be blocked. I select allow. Please remember that allowing or blocking these services depends on your specific needs and usage. Blocking some of these services to enhance security is generally safe. However, if you encounter any issues, return to the firewall pane and change the rules according to your needs.
If you like this video, make sure to subscribe and ring the bell for more. Thank you.
If you want to block incoming connections to a specific app, such as Clean App, click the plus button, then click Applications. In the left sidebar, select the app and click Open. The app will appear in this pane. Next, select Block or Allow from the drop-down menu for incoming connections. If you want to remove an app, click on it to select it, and then click on the minus button to remove it. The following two options are enabled by default. The first option permits all built-in software such as mail, FaceTime, messages, weather, and services signed by a valid certificate authority to receive incoming connections. I agree with this default setting and choose to leave it turned on. The second option allows automatically downloaded signed software to receive incoming connections without showing a warning. This means that if you download a third-party app from the internet, such as Microsoft Word, your Mac will permit incoming connections to access your system. However, if the toggle button is off, your Mac will display a warning. Do you want Microsoft Word to accept incoming network connections? You can select either allow or deny. If you trust the developer, click allow. If you have doubts, choose deny. You can permit incoming connections later when you are sure the app is safe. If you accidentally allow incoming connections, don't panic. Simply open the firewall application and select block from the drop-down menu. Enable stealth mode. This feature prevents your Mac from responding to incoming connections or ping requests, making it harder for hackers and malware to find your device. Nonetheless, it permits incoming requests from authorized applications to enhance your Mac security. Further, turn on the toggle button for stealth mode. You may already know that the macOS Firewall is designed to block incoming connections and not outgoing connections. If you are looking for a way to block outgoing connections, I have put together a detailed and easy-to-follow tutorial for you. The Firewall application is free and the tutorial is worth checking out. Take advantage of this opportunity to learn about a free firewall app and how to use it. Don't miss out. I leave the link to this tutorial in the description box below this video. I hope you learned something new today. If you did, please consider subscribing by clicking on the LT Lucid Tutorials logo and sharing the video link with your friends. Your support will inspire me to create more videos for you. Thank you for watching.